Hello and welcome to my Battle Cat guide on how to seed track. Seed tracking is a useful tool in viewing your upcoming cat capsule rolls, letting you plan ahead to get the units that you want with your saved up tickets and cat food. While the website that hosts the seed tracks explains most of the process quite well, there are a few things I find it could expand upon, which is the reason for me making this guide. The goal of this video is to explain the process of how to get started with seed tracking step by step, and then in the second half go over the functions of the website used for viewing your seed track. With that said, let's get into the game. Alright, so I am here on a fresh account with just enough cat food for a discounted multi-roll. To get started with seed tracking, you'd ideally want at least to have enough ticket or cat food saved up to roll about 7 to 8 times on the same banner. If you're rolling tickets, waiting for an epic fast banner might be the best. While if you're rolling a multi, wait for a banner with a guaranteed uber. But for the purpose of the guide, I'll be rolling a multi on the Elemental Pixies banner. As you roll, write down your results in the order you received them in. Once you've got your list of rolls, it's time for the next step. Now, open your web browser and go to this address as shown on the screen right now. From this screen, click on the purple target icon at the top. This brings you to where you need to be to start filling in your rolls. First of all, make sure you have the correct event banner selected for this. In my case, it's the Elemental Pixies one. Below that, it explains the process of how to get started on seed tracking. I've covered most of it in the earlier part of my video, but it might be helpful to read through it before taking the next step. For the next part, you select the units in the order you wrote them down in earlier, with one being your first roll result. Once you're done, hit the Seek button, which brings you to the next screen. Here, it will give you your seed that you can use to track. Since I did not roll for a guaranteed uber, the seed here, as shown on the screen, is the one I'll be using. And congrats, you have now successfully tracked your seed. But there's quite a lot of things to look at here, so let's go over every detail on this page, starting with the top row of items that you can ignore. These should be set correctly by default, so do not change them. Next up is the event banner. This is where you can select current and upcoming banners, as well as every banner that has appeared in the past, and view your results for each of them. Below that is your seed, which determines what roles you're getting in the game. As for the details button next to it, it's safe to ignore. Count will alter the range of roles shown on the page. By default, it will show you your first 100 upcoming roles. The last roll option will be useful for those rolling a smaller number of singles, where you can fill in each new roll one by one until the seed matches up with your in-game results. If you rolled 7 or more times to get your seed, ignore this. Find Next will let you search for a specific target unit. Let's say I want to know how many rolls I will need to get Foley on this banner. It will tell me the first Foley I will find is on 47 on the B track. Simulate Guaranteed does exactly what it says. It will display the guaranteed uber you'd be getting, even if the banner would normally not have a guaranteed uber event. Add future ubers will show your results in the case one or more new ubers may get added. Whenever this happens, your results may get altered, so beware of that. Finally, there's the found cat section, where it will normally display the exclusive and legendary rarity units, and at which roles you can expect to get them. For my particular seed, it says I'll be getting the legendary Lumina on 45 on the B track. Now we're getting to the actual seed reading part. Your last roll will always be at 0A, not shown on the tracks, and your very first next roll will always be 1A. For me, this is Archer Cat, which is correct since he was on my 11th roll in the multi I did, meaning the next unit I will roll from the cat capsules will be Delinquent Cat. Click on the last cat that you rolled in the game to move the seed tracker up to that point. I clicked on Archer Cat on 1A and it now displays the Delinquent Cat as my next roll. Since I still have a couple of rolls left, why don't we jump into the game and see if the seed tracker actually did its job correctly. And just like that, we got exactly the units the tracker told us we'd be getting, including air as my Uber on the third roll. Now knowing the seed tracker works as it should, we can look further ahead along the tracks of the seed. Here, at 41B, it tells me I should be getting Lumina, closely followed by Foley, but since we're on the A track, how are we getting over to the B track? Well, there are two ways of transferring over to the other track. The first one is looking for places where two of the same units are listed one after the other. For my seed, this happens with a gardener cat at 4A and then again at 5A. But since the game cannot roll the same unit twice in a row, it's forced to switch over to the B track, giving us the rocker cat on our fifth roll instead. Click on the rocker cat's name to display the switched tracks. Your previous B track has now become the A track. But let's say you want to switch back to the other track again. There's one other way of doing so. Rolling on a guaranteed Uber event switches your track with every multi you roll. To showcase this, I'll simulate the guaranteed for this banner, because there are no guaranteed Uber banners out right now. As you can see, if I were to roll a multi on this banner, if it had the guaranteed Uber event active, I would be getting all the units from 1A to 10A, with the 11th unit being air as the guaranteed Uber. After this, we have switched tracks over to B. Rolling a guaranteed Uber while there is also a track switch caused by a double unit in the middle of that multi will result in returning to the same track you just rolled on. Using this example, we switch over to track B with Rocker Cat, roll up to 10B, then get our boar as the guaranteed Uber and be sent back to 12 on track A afterwards. If you find it difficult to track where you will be going, you can click on the cell of the guaranteed Uber at 1A. The website will simulate the guaranteed multi, displaying the units you'd be getting in grey, and your first next roll in striped grey. To get rid of the grayed out cells, hit the back button on your browser. And one last thing, you can also use seed tracking to find out what you're getting from your platinum tickets. If I rolled a platinum ticket right now, copper mine would be the unit I'd be getting, as shown by the seed tracker here. Note that this also counts as a roll and moves the tracks along by one, but it cannot be used to switch over to the B track. If you don't intend to always keep the seed tracker tab open in your browser, it might be a good idea to copy over the seed or the URL after updating your tracks to a text file, as the number of your seed will change when updating it. Note that updating only changes the number of your seed and not your actual rolls. The rolls, as shown by the seed tracker, are set in stone for your account and cannot be altered. And that's it for this guide. I don't got an outro or anything, but I guess that if it was useful to you, please leave a like on the video.